What's happening, gamers? This is the New Infinix, and welcome to Super Star Wars The Empire Strikes Back one more time. So now, we are with Han Solo. We are not playing as the one and only Han Solo. Originally, Han Solo was to go pay Jabba the Hutt. But unfortunately, that payment will never ever come. Just so you know. Banta Pudu. Okay, so what we have to do in this stage right now is to try to find Princess Leia. Our next mission in this video is to get to the Millennium Falcon, and then one of my favorite fight scenes in a movie in outer space, avoiding the Empire by going into an asteroid field. Hurry up, Goldenrod! You're gonna be a permanent resident! Constantly annoyed by 3PO, Han Solo. By the way, I remember this movie that made fun of Star Wars called Spaceballs with Mel Brooks and John Candy and Bill Pullman. John Candy, may he rest in peace. That was a funny movie. And Daphne Zuniga, she was beautiful. Princess Vespa. Spaceball 1. They've gotten a plan. Also, a parody of Jabba the Hutt in Spaceballs is called Pizza the Hutt. I mean, they don't just only make fun of Star Wars, they make fun of everything. And also, the late Joan Rivers played as Dot Matrix, a parody of 3PO. Okay, so this time Han Solo doesn't start with a weak blaster, he starts with a flame blaster. If you guys have ever played Shadows of the Empire, after the Battle of Hoth, you had to escape from the Echo Base with Dash Rendar. At that time, Han was trying to escape from the Empire with Princess Leia. Unfortunately, he could not go jump into light speed because. Actually, in terms of the movie, I think Harrison Ford did an amazing job playing as Han Solo. He was born to play that role. Too bad he supports gun control, though, Harrison Ford. Yeah. is that they added the theme of the asteroid field. Oh, I forgot to mention that another thing about Han Solo is that he has a bomb, grenades. Oh, you gotta watch out for these guys. They can be very annoying. Now I wish I was playing this loose so I can quickly dispatch those guys. Okay, so here comes the boss of the stage. Good thing I got the seeker missiles. They work effectively on missiles this way. It's okay. Third time's a charm. Escaping from the Echo Base. And this time we're out to rescue Princess Leia, so then we can get to the Millennium Falcon. However, there's another boss in this one. Thank you. Williams is a god. Okay, elevator going up. More grenades. Actually, I'm pretty lucky. We do not have gotten a game over so far. Who doesn't love those lines? Okay, ladies and gentlemen, now we are in the asteroid field. Our objective in the asteroid field is to destroy 15 TIE fighters in order to escape. The TIE fighters will appear behind you, and you see the radar? The radar, when they turn green, that's when you're in front of them. Make sure to shoot them down. Oh, and by the way, because you're in an asteroid field, you have to watch out for all the asteroids that come at you. For some reason, this reminds me of Star Fox. Oh well, but, you know, video games like Star Fox and all the other stuff, they just, like, pay tribute to Star Wars and Star Trek and other fictional, like, outer space stories like Battlestar Galactica and so on. Speaking of Battlestar Galactica, I gotta sit and tell you, man, Trisha Helfer is so freaking hot. And Kitty Sackhoff, too. have 5 more enemies left. The only thing I gotta worry about is the asteroids getting me. Too bad the hyperdrive was messed up in the movie. Impossible for them to go to light speed. Okay, now we got him. Funny how in this game to make the jump to light speed. Meanwhile, in a different part of the galaxy, Luke goes to the Dagobah system to seek the training and guidance of Yoda. So, time for me to wrap this up, ladies and gentlemen. So, God bless, play hard, gamers, and may the Force be with you. See you later, gamers. Bye.